Hey, welcome to this video on trend trading the stock market with Heikkan Ashi Candlestick Charts. Today, we're going to show you how to identify trend with a different type of candlestick. So the nice thing is that it really is able to show you trends much more simply and clearly. I simplify it down to really three patterns. The first one is your bullish pattern. So I've got my bars colored green and red. A lot of times though, the up moves will be hollow and the down moves will be filled in with whatever color. So a bullish candle, a very bullish candle is something like, well, all of these actually, where it's green or the close is above the open, and there's no wick at the bottom. That's the key. In normal candlesticks, you're going to see with these, and we'll show you a comparison of the same chart, where there's a wick above and a wick below. But on the Heikkan Ashi bars, when there's no wick at the bottom, then, and it's colored green in my case, then that is a bullish trending up bar. So very important, very cool, very easy to read. You know, it just simplifies things. That's what I like about these, is it simplifies things. Then the second type of bar is exactly the opposite, and that would be a red bar like this. So it's going down, and you'll have wicks on the bottom, but no wick on the top. And so that's a bearish trending bar. Now these are rather narrow range. So another aspect of this is, what's the range of the bar? The wider the range, the more trending they tend to be. So these are still pretty narrow range. Also, let me add here that you need to take these into consideration along with other things on the chart. I would never trade these alone. So moving averages, for example, here I've got this black line is the 15 EMA. This green line is the 50 simple moving average. Whatever indicators that you want to use, support resistance, trend lines, whatever you use this in conjunction with them. Do not use this alone. Okay, so those are your two primary types of bars. Now the third type of bar is where you have wicks above and below the real body. The real body, if you're not familiar, is the colored part of the bar. So here we have, well, it's slightly red. Here we've got one that's slightly green, but we've got wicks above and below the real body of the bar. Now, you'll hear a lot of people say that that indicates a trend change. I disagree with that personally. Again, I don't always teach the classical stuff. I teach you what comes from my experience. And so I just consider those basically neutral bars. And some of the people who talk about this a little more knowledgeably than others, they will say that they are neutral bars, but neutrality comes before trend change. So yeah, that's okay. I can understand that, but I just think it's a bad idea to put the idea that trend change is going to occur just because you have neutrality. You can get neutrality like here, for example. Actually, this is a great example of it, where the market just takes a little rest and then resumes the uptrend. That's a very, very common thing. So if you're in an uptrend here, I definitely wouldn't go short just because of those bars. Yeah, maybe take some profits if you're already long, and then, you know, keep some if it goes longer. And again, trade this with everything else. Now let's compare these Heikkan Ashi bars with a regular chart. All right, so now we have a regular candlestick bar chart on the right, same market. And what you see here is that the patterns are very different. So let's go back and look at the patterns that we talked about. So here is a bullish bar with no wick on the bottom. Well, if we go over here, we've got a big wick on the bottom. Okay, tremendously huge wick below the real body. So is this signal better than that one? Not necessarily better or worse. I mean, in my opinion, again, that is a bullish candlestick pattern. They're just different. You read them differently. Read them differently. As I said, we don't want any wick below here for it to be an uptrend. And, you know, if you look at this, you can just kind of see that, for example, in here, might be a little confusing. Oh, here's another interesting point. So we've got gaps here. We get a gap there. We get a gap here. Now, on the Heikkan Ashi charts, you have no gaps. no gaps. So if you love to read gaps, then either have a regular candlestick bar next to it, or just don't trade Heikin Ashi because it's not going to give you gap signals. The way I look at it is, as long as we get a run like this, where there's no wicks on the bottom until there, there's really no reason to get out. Okay, and that's what this is great for. It really works best in trending environments. So, extra little thing there, simplifies the looking at your charts and identifying trends. It creates nice smooth patterns when we get into trends. And for example, here's another thing. You'll look at something like this over here, and you might, you might get scared out of your position here. Whereas over here, it's still showing, nope, still bullish, still bullish, still bullish. And, you know, even in here, little tiny bars, and you might get a little nervous about that. No, still stay in. This is your first signal that, okay, maybe things are weakening here a little bit. And then it resumes and continues right on back up. So that to me is not bearish. That's not a reversal signal. I think that's crazy when people talk about that. But it's pausing. And markets often do that, right? They move up and then they pause and they wait. And that reflects the psychology of the people trading the markets. Is the more the market goes, people start to get a little nervous and say, well, can this really continue going? I don't know. I'm feeling a little hesitation now. I'm not feeling as certain as before. And we see that reflected in the charts. The charts are the map of the market psychology. And so you see people's mass psychology, their actions and reactions mapped on the charts. So, hey, try it, put it on a chart, look at a few charts, use it with other tools that you're using, and see what you think. See if you think this could be a good addition to your trading. So if you like this video, please understand that, sure, it's free, but if you really got value from it, then you do have a moral obligation to pay it forward by clicking the little share button below and share it on social media, because, hey, it feels good. It's a spiritual thing to do, to share good stuff. And if you're watching this on YouTube, I also invite you to click the thumbs up icon below and leave a comment. That really encourages me to keep making these free videos for you. I'm also giving away my favorite trade strategy. It's called the rubber band trade. It's a very simple trade, and it has a very high win-loss ratio. I can teach you this in about 26 minutes on a video explaining the trade strategy, which you can get absolutely free by clicking on that image in the top left corner, or if you're on a mobile device, click on the little eye with a circle around it in the top right corner of this video. And if you're not watching on YouTube, then there's probably a link below or an opt-in form on the side. Once you do that, I will personally email the video to you with the rubber band trade strategy.